Hello everyone, in this video I will explain to you guys how to use the CoinPanel platform and how it will help you with your trading. So first, let's talk about how it is right now on the exchange. You can already trade on the exchange, but this has some problems and limitations. When you're trading on the exchange, you cannot use a stop loss and a target order together. You're limited to one of them. Because of this reason, you have to monitor the markets all day or set price alarms to know when the price is dropping or if it's increasing, so that you come back to your computer to sell at a loss or sell at a profit. And also, to check your profits and losses, you have to use another app. So what we did here with CoinPanel is that we combined all of these needs that you have as a trader all in one platform, so that you can have a stress-free trading experience. Start by going to CoinPanel website and clicking the Get Started button to create your account. After you have your account set, go to the login page and log in with your new account. After you've logged in, you will be welcomed with this screen where you need to integrate your exchange. CoinPanel is your personal trading assistant that connects to your exchange account. So you need to have an exchange account in order to use CoinPanel. Keep in mind that we only support Binance.com right now, and Binance.com and Binance US are different exchanges. We only support Binance.com right now, and we will be supporting more exchanges in June. If you don't have a Binance account and you'd like to set up one, click this link to set up a Binance account. If you already have one, click continue with existing Binance account. So here, I need to connect my Binance account to CoinPanel. Give this name anything you want. I will call it main because this is my main Binance account. So you need to get your API key and API secret codes from your Binance account in order to connect your account to CoinPanel. So let's go to the Binance website. Here on the top right, I hover over this icon and then I click API management. Here I will be creating a new API key to use with CoinPanel. Call it whatever you want here. And then click create API. Now you need to send a code to your email, and also you need to pass your code from the Google Authenticator to confirm this action. After you confirmed, your API keys are now created and ready to be used on CoinPanel. Copy this API key and paste it into the key section on CoinPanel. Then copy the secret key and paste it on the secret on CoinPanel. Then I click continue. And now my account is set up and I'm ready to use CoinPanel. I click start the CoinPanel experience. You will be welcomed with a quick tutorial on how to use the features. I'm skipping this tour for now. So now in this screen, I can see the chart here, the trading view chart, my open orders, my order history, and the trading panel. And also I have the positions and the portfolio tabs. Trade screen is where you will be creating your trades. Position screen is where you will be automatically tracking your profits and losses. And the portfolio screen is where you can check your portfolio. So I'm going to go back to another setup account to walk you through all these features. Okay. So let's start by talking about why you need CoinPanel to execute your trading strategy, guys. If you'd like to be a serious trader, you gotta have a strategy. And a strategy consists of an entry where you buy the coin, a stop loss, the maximum amount of loss that you're willing to take, and the take profit targets. In order to execute the strategy, how are you doing this today? You either have to sit in front of your computer and check the prices all the time, or you have to set price alerts. And then you get notified on your phone, okay, my stop loss reached. I have to come back to my computer or my mobile phone to sell. Take profit one reached. I need to go back and sell 25%. You have to do all these manually. And why is this? Is because if you create a stop loss order on Binance using the stop limit feature, then you're not gonna be able to create a take profit order with the same balance, guys. Because if you create one order with one Bitcoin, let's say, that one Bitcoin is going to be locked in your stop loss order and it's going to be unavailable to use for another order. This is why you cannot use a stop loss and a take profit order at the same time on exchanges. So what CoinPanel lets you do with our full trade feature is to automate the whole strategy that you have, the entry, the stop loss, and the take profits. So in this trading view chart here, I would like to create a trade on Bitcoin market. So with this tool right here, I can quickly use this tool to place an entry here. So now with this tool on the graphical interface, I'll be able to modify my take profit and my stop loss. After I modify these things according to my strategy, I have the values on the right of the chart. The stop loss is in red, your entry is in gray, and your target is in green. So I want to actually have three targets here. So I want to put two more targets above my first target. So I set my targets, my stop loss, and my entry on the chart. Now I'm ready to set it up on CoinPanel so that it automates this strategy for me. On the full trade panel, you'll be first shown an entry order. The first step is your entry order, guys. As you can see in the entry order, you have different types of orders that you can use. If you use a limit order, your order will be placed at this price and it will be filled when that price is reached. If you create a market order, that means you will be buying now. If you use a stop limit order, you have some other options. And if you use a stop market order, that is going to execute a market order when a price is reached. So why would you use a stop market order, for example? Let's say you have a trend line and you want to buy the breakout of this trend line. So if you are here and you want to buy the breakout of this trend line, then you can use a stop market or stop limit entry for your full trade. So it will actually buy when this breaks out of the channel. But for this current scenario, I will be using a limit order because the price that I want to buy is lower than the current price. So I put my limit order at 34497.29. Using this slider, I'm able to specify how much percentage of my balance am I willing to use for this trade. So I'm going to create with 100% of my balance with a $43 total value of this trade. After you set up your entry, you click next exits to go to set up your exits. So as you can see, once I created my entry order, the trade overview appeared, which shows that the full trade that I'm creating. So I can see my entry order, my buy order at this price. Now the next step is to set your stop loss and targets. You can see a control here that will switch between the target and stop loss panels. On the target panel, you'll be creating your targets. And on the stop loss panel, you'll be creating your stop loss. So I will start by placing my stop loss. I can see on the chart that my stop loss is at 31,692.60. So I'm risking a maximum amount of 8.13% of my initial investment. The slider below sets how much of your initial investment are you willing to stop out in this trade. So if you want to exit only half of your position if the price drops, then you can put it at 50%. In this scenario, I want to cancel all my trade and exit my position So I will be using 100% in my stop loss. Then I click add stop loss to create my stop loss order. As you can see, my stop loss now appeared in the trade overview. So I have my buy order set, my stop loss order set. Now I'm going to set up my targets. I switch to the target panel. So let's start with my first target. My first target is at 41.931.93. And as you can see, as I put the price in, it's gonna show me how much percentage profit I'm aiming at this target. So at 22% profit, I would like to sell 25% of my initial investment. I add target one. Now my target one is in the trade overview. I go to my second target. At the second target, I want to sell another 25% of my initial investment. And I click add target two, and it's in my trade overview. Now, the last target. So I set up the trade to sell 25% at one target one, another 25% at target two. So I have 50% left. So I want to place the remaining 50% at target three. Now I can have an overall look of my full trade. I have my buy order set at this price, my three targets set at these prices, and my stop loss set at this price. I'm able to check how much of my initial investment amount I am selling on each target and how much of the initial investment I'm willing to stop out when my stop loss hits. So then you click place full trade. And then you're going to see a screen where you need to confirm everything. So you can double check everything here. Your take profits, stop loss, how much of it you're selling, which prices at you're selling, and then you click confirm. Now your full trade is set, guys. So you're used to the open orders on Binance. You're seeing all your open orders, right? So you'll be able to see a full trade type on CoinPanel, which means that this is not just one order, but this is a full trade that consists of an entry, stop loss, and one or more targets. You can use this expand button here to see all of your full trade. So now I'm able to see that I have an entry limit order at this price. I have stop market orders for my stop losses and targets, and I can see my stop loss and targets on the chart. So now you just automated your whole trade, and when your stop loss is reached, it's going to stop out your position. When your targets are reached, it's going to trigger your targets and make you profit. So if you were to do this on Binance, let's say your take profit one is reached. Now you sold 25% of your balance. Let's say the second target is reached. Now you sold 50% of your balance. So 50% of what you initially bought is left. So what you would have to do here normally is that if the price drops here down to your stop loss again, you need to adjust your stop loss amount because you only have 50% of your initial investment. So what CoinPanel will do for you guys is that once your take profit one is executed, it's going to automatically adjust your stop loss amount, deducting the amount that you sold at take profit one. When it reaches take profit two, it's going to deduct that amount from the stop loss. So now your stop loss has the correct amount that you have left, and it will execute with the amount that you have left in your investment. So the whole strategy is automated for you. This is the full trade feature, guys. We also have the place order feature, which lets you do exactly what you're doing on Binance. We created this feature so that you don't have to switch between the Binance and the CoinPanel applications. All the trades that you're creating on Binance, you can create on CoinPanel using the place order feature. So place order feature means, guys, that you're just placing an order. Full trade means that you're placing an order that is consisting of an entry, stop loss, and targets. So in the place order feature, I can use the buy and sell panels to simply create orders. A limit order, a market order to buy now. But what else that I can do is I can place stop loss and take profits for the coins that I already have. So let's say I already bought this coin. I don't want to set a full trade then because I already bought this coin. So I want to set my stop loss and targets. So if you have already bought the coin, you go to place order, sell panel. Be very careful here, guys. Do not use a limit order to set your take profit or your stop losses. This is because the limit order is going to block your balance and you're not going to be able to use the same balance to create another order. So the feature that you need to use here for stop losses is the stop market feature. So I click the stop market order type. I confirm that this is selected with the blue line under it. And now I'm setting a stop loss at 32,000. I have my stop loss set at 32,000, which means that this is going to sell when this price is reached. As you can see when you hover on this trade, is that this order is waiting to be placed in the order book. It's not in the order book yet. And this is how I'm going to be able to create a take profit order as well. So I go to the take profit market feature. I'll put my price in. So now I have my take profit and my stop loss order set as stop market order type. Don't get confused with the stop market order type, guys. This is just the order type. This is the trading terminology, but this means that when this price is reached up here, it's going to sell your Bitcoin. When this price is reached down here, it's also going to sell your Bitcoin. So using these take profit market and stop market features, you were just able to create a stop loss and a target order simultaneously, which you cannot do on Binance. Let's jump into the positions tab, guys. In the positions tab, you can see the positions that you currently have, and you can check your live profits and losses. And when you hover over the entry price here, you're going to be able to see where you actually bought this coin. And if you took some profit, like in this case, I bought at 22.48 and 22.46, and I sold some at 22.62. So you're going to be able to check where you actually bought and where you exited these positions in the positions tab. What you do right now to check your profits is that you have to use another app than the exchange, and then you have to manually put your trades in. I bought this coin at this price. I sold the partial amount at this price. You need to put all those details in manually so that you can check how much profit you're making. With CoinPanel, this is automatically calculated and it's automatically shown to you how much profit you're making, where you entered your position, where you exited, what's the current price, how much you bought, when you opened your position, and all those things. Let's go to the portfolio tab. The portfolio tab is pretty straightforward, guys. Here you're going to be able to see your balances and keep track of your live value of your portfolio. Thanks for joining us today, guys, in this quick tutorial. We have 24/7 support available. If you have any further questions, please contact our support using the help button below and we will respond to you immediately.